and welcome. This presentation was brought to you by the Vigilant Society of Engineers. I thank you for giving me the opportunity to share it with you and to all electrical engineering professionals working in the field. Today, we'll focus on the interconnected power production sources under Article 705. And this presentation will give us a diverse view of power production sources, how we establish the necessary protection for the connected and so forth. Alright, we'll delve into how we parallel the system with other primary sources. Now, the introduction for electrical power sources. Under Article 705, installation of one or more electrical power production sources operating in parallel with primary sources of electricity can be established. Alright, these provide the guidelines for which persons who are about to install another independent power production sources with other primary sources. So power sources include systems that produce power, including utility sources and sources on premises such as a rotating generator. When it comes to interconnected power production sources, we should put safety on the highest agenda. Interconnected power production sources introduce hazard due to the system operating in parallel with a primary sources. A competent person must have the skill to recognize and associate the system. We cannot compromise when it comes to safety. A person must be able to identify the hazard that can introduce into the system. Therefore, we should identify somebody who is qualified and competent enough to deal with such hazard. Interconnected power production sources, such as PV array, generator, or a primary incoming source, can be provided with an inverter, which can be used to convert the PV signal that's from a DC to an AC. The interactive inverter may also be used for conditioning purpose, therefore providing a better signal or generator incoming power supply. And it's also used to interact with the primary incoming source. Electrical power sources and power production equipment. Such includes the generating sources and all the distributed equipment associated with it. An example of power production equipment includes rotating generator system, solar photovoltaic system, and fuel cell system. Photovoltaic system, as illustrated by this diagram, shows a grid-connected EV system utilizing solar panel arrays. This system comprises of combiner box, DC PV disconnect mains, as well as inverter. Alright, an inverter is used to change the array output into an AC output. Now, from the inverter, it is sent to a breaker panel and then distributed to the household. Now, a kilowatt hour meter can be used to measure the amount of output from the entire system. Now, associated power equipment, such may include utility interactive inverter. Now, this equipment is very critical in aligning like a PV system or windmill system on a utility grid or to synchronize with a primary source. So the conductor between the utility interactive inverter supply the service equipment and interact between another electric power production source, such as a utility source. The point of connection. The point of connection of the interconnected electrical power source shall be connected to the supply side of the service disconnect means. Alright? Now, the output shall be permitted to be interconnected at a point or elsewhere on the premises where a system qualifies as an integrated electrical system and incorporated protective device. Therefore, what the condition it is, there must be some protective device. The conductor sizing should be appropriate, that when it is tapped into the system, it does not create any form of hazard. And that is why we say that there must be a person qualified and competent to do this kind of work. Point of connection for utility interactive inverter output. Now, the output of a utility interactive inverter shall be permitted to be connected to load side of the service disconnect means of the sources at any distribution equipment on premises. Such equipment may include a switchgear, switchboard, or panel board. The utility interconnected inverter connection should be made at a dedicated circuit breaker or feasible disconnect means to provide protection for the power source. The ampacity requirement for the feeder or the top conductor shall be 125% of the inverter output circuit current. Now, what does that mean? The feeder top should be sized at a value much greater than what is delivered from the inverter output circuit. An overcurrent protective device must not be greater than the ampacity of the feeder top. Bus bar shall represent the sum of all the overcurrent protective device for both the load and the supply device connected to the bus bar. Therefore, all the taps, all the feeders coming to the bus bar should be equal to the magnitude of the ampacity of the bus bar. So, the point of connection for larger production system. The output shall be permitted to be connected at a point or elsewhere on the premises where all conditions are met. So, for larger production system, the aggregate of the non-utility source has a capacity in excess where it is 100 kilowatt or the service is above 1,000 volts. Alright? This should meet the condition of maintenance and supervision and ensure that qualified person servicing a the system. Such system should safeguards and document it and provide procedures regarding protective equipment as established for maintenance. Where a larger system is concerned, the point of connection can be made at a service point or at a point elsewhere on the premises. Exhibit 705.1 gives us an illustration of how a connection can be made with your utility equipment. Alright. So, the output of a generator or the other production sources shall meet the requirements to operate in parallel with electrical supply. The system shall be compatible with the voltage, wave shape, and frequency of the system that is connected. Therefore, the condition for the output of the unit, it should match up with that that is coming from the primary source in order for them to actually work together. Protection system. Consideration shall be given to the contribution of fault current from all interconnected power sources for interrupting and short-circuiting current rating of equipment on interactive system. Therefore, when there's a condition that arises due to fault current entering the system, there should be some means for isolating the system to protect it against, you know, those wild card equipment and conductor connected to more than one electrical sources shall have overcurrent protection located to protect from all sources. All right, so that's what we mentioned earlier. Over protection must be in place to protect the source being delivered to service equipment. Backfed breaker. A circuit breaker, if backfed, shall be suitable for such operation of utility interactive inverters. In regards to labeling, it is very important that the incoming source is identified, whether it is a wind power generated source, a PV generated source, or a utility generated source. So a circuit breaker shall be marked and labeled to indicate the presence of the power source. When it comes to control, our control system, control must involve monitoring interconnected interactive utility equipment for the frequency, the voltage, wave shape, irrespective of the power source. Now, output characteristics of rotating generated source is different in comparison to solid state source. Now, the feedback characteristics should ensure that the unit operates safely without any hazard introduced into it. The control of power production source, such as rotating generator, should include real power or reactive power. And this might include the harmonic content of the output. Rotating equipment is known for its kVA rating, and that is split in between the real power and the reactive power. The control of the prime mover control the amount of real power flow out of the system, and in the case of the reactive power, we can control that through the excitation or the voltage that is delivered to the system. Okay guys, thanks for your interest in this presentation, and stay tuned for more. Make sure you register to our engineering platform at www.regionalsocietyofengineers.com for more information on interconnected power production sources. Take care.